company, guess where you can also find some cool stuff? At their website. This is Starbucks.com. In fact, what I'd like you to do is you start to study your company. Get all of this at the same time, but why don't you do a soft approach and study the company through their website first. If you come to Starbucks.com, you start to learn about the company from the consumer's perspective. By the way, this thing has 900 calories in it, okay? Huh? No, that's a lie. This ice cube has 140 calories. So come, here's the lesson. Come all the way down to the bottom, and this is Evol.com public corporations. About us, our company, stories and news, investor relations. Ah, let's go to investor relations. Okay, so this is where you get all the pretty accessible value. Fiscal year results, most recent results, you've got the 10Q is a quarterly financial, 10K is the yearly. Fiscal earnings, more, you got reports all over the place. SEC filings, 10Q, earnings release, you can go back 2011 on this exact site. For some of you in our, some of you might be taking my 102 class. You can also come over here to look at social impact. You're gonna probably see their corporate responsibility filings, all of that kind of stuff is easily accessible through the website. Any questions about any of this? The next thing I want to show you just very briefly in our remaining time are a couple of examples of your first assignment, major assignment for the marketing plan, and that's what we'll call stage one. Got some samples of stage one down here. Let's take a look at one. This is one. So this is what you're going to be doing. I'm not going to post these just because I'm not, so pay attention. And I also want you to get the general idea and make it kind of your own. You don't have to take pictures of it, just follow me and pay attention, okay? So you have here an example of Coca-Cola. It's a two-page assignment. You have the company profile. Probably a lot of this stuff is from MarketLine. We're gonna want a five-year financial review of revenue, net income. I'm going to give you a little bit more advice on what we want in here. It looks like selling, administration, and other expenses, which we were talking about just a moment ago, and the stock price. At bare minimum, I want total revenue 5 years, the stock price of the last year, closing December 31st of the previous year, and net income, right? The current marketing situation is a marketing plan, foundational content, if you will. So current marketing situation, overview of the product, overview of the marketing initiatives, overview of the competition, overview of distribution. This person went above and beyond and put some references. That's totally fine. It's you know, this is a two-page assignment. I think if I remember correctly, this is a 10-point font, single-space, Times New Roman document. So now is the time to make the decision on the company and make the decision on starting your research. Let's take a look at a couple more. So this is another one. This is Bath and Body Works. It isn't doing too well. Same kind of thing. PepsiCo. Google. So this student didn't listen, and Google is a service and not a tangible product. Sometimes those sneak in or escape our oversight, or a TA, with all due respect to the TA, doesn't catch it. That's fine. I'm reminding you, tangible product that has a specific clear marketing mix. You know what the product is, you know how much it costs to the consumer, you know its distribution, and you know its promotion, okay? And then let's take a final look at, this is just one of many samples that I'll show you throughout the next few weeks of a final project. This is what it's going to look like. You can see that you have table of contents. Let's look at the table of contents. There's your current marketing situation again. Market, product, competitive, marketing channels, distribution. The SWOT analysis, strategic objectives and issues. The marketing strategy, again, we're going to be giving you all of this as a framework. Action programs, controls, and references. This is what it looks like here. This is double space. I think it's 12-point font. It's quite nice. It has some attention to detail, as you can see. Just a little reference. Try to avoid dangling subheadings like that. So that's where we're headed. Any advice? Week three.
Make sure you have these samples memorized. And make sure that if you're looking at the stock price, you don't know what you're most likely trying to use, and you can send it to the stock price.
So what he said, if you can't hear him, start researching your company now through the tools that I've shown you today. But he's right. We're going to, you know, use the stock price ending at the end of the year. Do you know the difference between a fiscal year and the calendar year? And while we're at it, go to camp